Good evening. I'm Dr. Monica, final year resident. Today I'm going to present paper on role of CT in evaluation of pancreatic lesions. Introduction. Pancreatic lesions are now an increasingly common occurrence and a significant cause of morbidity and mortality. Pancreatitis is one of the most complex and clinically challenging of all abdominal disorders. Modalities for imaging pancreas range from plain X-ray to ultrasound, endoscopic ultrasound, ERCP, CT, MRI, and PET-CT. With the introduction of CT, evaluation of pancreatic lesions allows data to be acquired during optimal pancreatic enhancement. The advent of triple phase contrast study aids in early detection of small and early pancreatic lesions. The use of multiplanar reformatted images and three-dimensional representations of vascular structures helps in accurate staging of pancreatic tumors and aids in successful surgical resection. Aims and objectives: to assess the role of CT in evaluation and characterization of various inflammatory, neoplastic, and traumatic pancreatic lesions, to measure and assess the attenuation values of various pathologies, to classify pancreatic tumors based on imaging findings and correlate them pathologically wherever possible, to evaluate pancreatic trauma cases. Materials and methods. This study evaluating the role of CT triple phase in the pancreatic pathologies was done on 40 patients. Demographic details like age, gender, and clinical symptoms were collected. Clinical details with particular emphasis on risk factors and relevant lab parameters were collected from records and reviewed for all patients. Scans were performed on 16-slide CT. Observation and results. Out of 40 patients in the study, maximum number of patients were under the age group of 20 to 39 years, which consisted of 15 patients, accounting to 37.5%. Gender-wise distribution of all cases. Out of 40 cases in the study, males were 27 in number and females were 13 in number. Pathological distribution of all cases. Out of 40 cases, 45% were acute pancreatitis, which includes 20% interstitial edematous pancreatitis and 25% of necrotizing pancreatitis cases. Acute on chronic pancreatitis includes 20% cases. Chronic pancreatitis includes 12.5% cases, and tumors include 20%, and trauma includes 2.5% cases. Pseudocyst and wall of necrosis distribution in pancreatitis patients. In this study, acute on chronic pancreatitis and chronic pancreatitis, there is increase in occurrence of pseudocyst accounting to 62.5% and 80% cases respectively. Few cases of interstitial edematous pancreatitis and necrotizing pancreatitis were found to have pseudocyst. Wall of necrosis is seen only in necrotizing pancreatitis. Calcification pattern in distribution in pancreatitis. Out of 32 cases of pancreatitis, only 7 cases showed calcifications, in which intraparenchymal calcifications alone is seen in 4 cases, and both intraparenchymal and interductal calcification is seen in 3 cases. Modified CT-CBRT score grading in acute pancreatitis. Majority of interstitial edematous pancreatitis cases have fallen under moderate grade, and necrotizing pancreatitis cases have fallen under severe grade. Distribution of tumor nature. Out of 6 cases of neoplasms, majority were malignant. Location of tumor. Most common location of malignant tumors was found to be head. Benign lesions were equally seen in head and tail region. This is a case of interstitial edematous pancreatitis, in which the pancreas is bulky edematous with mild peripancreatic fat stranding and peripancreatic fluid collections. This is a case of necrotizing pancreatitis, in which the head, body and tail of pancreas is bulky with parenchymal necrosis and peripancreatic fat stranding. This is a case of acute on chronic pancreatitis. There is diffuse enlargement of pancreas with multiple pancreatic parenchymal calcifications along with peripancreatic fat stranding. This is a case of chronic pancreatitis. In this, there is thinning of pancreatic parenchyma with dilatation of main pancreatic duct and atrophy of parenchyma. This is a case of pancreatic tumor. There is a well-defined thin-walled cystic lesion in the head of pancreas, having few calcific foci in the wall. These are the features suggestive of benign cystic neoplasm of pancreas, likely mucinous cystadenoma. Discussion. Pancreatic lesions are now an increasingly common occurrence and a significant cause of morbidity and mortality. Pancreatitis is one of the most complex and clinically challenging of various abdominal disorders. Various pancreatic pathologies. The pancreatic pathologies are broadly classified into five groups: developmental anomalies, inflammatory conditions, tumors, infiltrative metabolic and other disorders, and trauma. These are the different pancreatic pathologies. Summary. A prospective study of 40 patients was carried out in suspected cases of pancreatic abnormality with CT in triple phase using a specific protocol. The results were as follows. Neoplasms are more common in females with an male-to-female ratio of 1:4. With increase in age, there is shift in frequency of cases from inflammatory to neoplasm. Wall of necrosis was seen only in cases of necrotizing pancreatitis with high significance stating its specificity. In chronic pancreatitis, majority of cases had atrophic pancreas with dilated MPD, pancreatic parenchymal calcification, and pseudocyst. In pancreatic neoplasm, head of the pancreas is most common location. Ascites, pleural effusion, and thrombosis are complications observed among various pathologies. Conclusion. To conclude, as per our study, CT with triple phase imaging protocol of pancreas helps in better evaluation of various pancreatic pathologies with detection of lesions as small as 1.5 centimeters in size and assessment of resectability of a neoplastic lesion, thus aiding in better accurate diagnosis of pathologies and in further treatment planning. These are my references.